所以我们要看见世界上面很多的大事，其实是神要保存着他的余民。
So when we look at a lot of big things in the world, we need to understand it is God's move to protect His remnant.
然后，经这一次的 COVID 的洗礼
，and through this baptism of COVID this time，
是神的怜悯
，it is God's mercy。
不是为了其他人
，not for other people，
是为了他的余民
，but for his remnant。
因为神不希望这一个样的这个 COVID 的没完没了的这个一年半载的过去，继续下去。
Because、God doesn't want this COVID to continue endlessly for another year or so。
送他所生来一次的巅峰
，so he just brings it to its summit to its peak。
我真的是非常阿门的
，and I truly amen.
Like bring it on, you know, baptize us, you know.Bring it on, let everybody catch it. 然后这个整个美国在两个月之后就好像这个 Phoenix 浴火的那个火凤凰浴火重生。
And then in 2 months, USA will be rising as the Phoenix, like、yeah. reborn again.
那我们也没有死人啊。
And、nobody passed away or got killed.
Yeah, 我们只是更强壮。
We just become stronger.
更属灵。
And more spiritual.
更聪明。
And smarter.
更明白神在这个时代里面的旨意。
And more understanding to the Lord's will in this era.
好，现在呢，我要，这是我预备了一个，本来预礼拜一的时候呢，预备好一个千禧年的密契境界，是一个非常好的信息。
So I prepared a message called the Mystical Realm in the Millennium for today.
但是呢，我今天在一起看的时候，我觉得这太严肃了。
But when I'm reading it today, I feel that it is too serious.
但是我现在今天就是很开心。
So today,
我希望大家不要讲的太 serious， 但是这个是也可以告诉你一点。
So today I'm in a joyful mode. I don't want to be too serious with you, but I can share a little bit.
刚才我们谈到这个 COVID 的事情呢，我觉得是非常大家需要了解的。
So just now when I was sharing about COVID, it is something that is important. I think everyone should understand.
我们看见这个先几年，我们是慢几年，先几年，然后先几年呢是慢慢的 unfold， 它不是 bang， 就是 like 变成千禧年。
So we are entering into the millennium, and the millennium gradually unfolds. It doesn't come in a bang.
Yeah. 所以在千禧年里面呢，会有什么的不一样呢
？So what is different in the millennium？
就是我觉得是神把旧约里面所有的君王体系，新约里面的君王体系。在先几年里面是带到一个更高的境界。
I feel that God is bringing from the Old Testament, the kingship system in the Old Testament, to the kingship system in the New Testament, through to the millennium to bring forth an even greater kingship system.
然后神也会把旧约的先知境界带到新约的先知境界，带到先几年的先知境界一个更高境界。
And God is also taking the prophetic realm from the Old Testament to the New Testament and then to the millennium, bringing it to its height.
然后又会把旧约的祭祀境界带到新约的祭祀境界，来带到先几年的祭祀现境界，带到一个更高的境界。
And he's also taking the priesthood realm from the Old Testament to the New Testament and to its peak in the millennium.
Okay, 留心听
listen
up. Okay.基督教里面有三个大的体系。
In Christianity, there are three main systems.
第一个就是君王。
One is kingship.
主耶稣就是王。
Jesus is king.
所以我们也要与他同作王。
So we will reign with Christ as king.
Okay. 所以在旧约里面有王。
So in the Old Testament, there are kings.
在新约里面都有王，我会告诉你。
In the New Testament,
在教会里面有王的灵。
There are also kingship in the church. I'm going to show you.
然后先几年都有。
And also in the millennium.
基督教第二个环节就是先知。
And the second system in Christianity is the prophetic system.
主耶稣就是先知。
And Jesus himself is prophet.
Yeah, 这个先知代表就是带神，代表神来说话。
And prophet represents that God speaking.
带出神的信息
，to bring forth God's messages。
但是主耶稣特别的地方，因为他就是这个话。
And what is special about Jesus is that He Himself is the message.
所以旧约的先知代表神说话。
So Old Testament prophet, they speak for God.
新约的先知全讲神的话。
And the New Testament, they also speak the word of God.
现几年的先知更加讲神的心。
And in the millennium, the prophets also speak the heart of God.
Okay, 基督教第三个大的系统就是祭司。
And then the third system in Christianity, it is priesthood.
在旧约里面有祭司。
In the Old Testament, there is priesthood.
在新约里面的教会里面的 clergy 就是祭司。
And in the New Testament, the church, the clergy of the church is priesthood.
然后到了先几年呢，又有一个更高的祭司境界。
And then in the millennium, there is an even higher priesthood.
这一个祭司呢，我们要看在旧约里面就已经开始了教会。
So this priesthood, we need to understand that actually church already begun in the Old Testament.
如果你真的去研究神学，
if you really study theology,
你问所有的神学家，
you ask all the theologians,
教会什么时候开始？
When did the church start?
是创世纪第三章。
It is Genesis chapter 3.
你知道家庭的祭坛啊，
you know the family altar?
Yeah.就是亚当夏娃被赶出伊甸园。
That Adam and Eve were casted out of the Garden of Eden.
是吗？他们跟儿子们呢谈到神呢，谈到这个神宰这个羊给他们。
And they were talking to their children about God and that God has sacrificed a lamb and clothed them.
这一个家庭的祭坛就是教会。
And this family altar is the church.
这个原则是教会。
And that in principle is the church.
所以在旧约里面呢，希伯来谈到在旷野里面那个会幕，其实就是旷野里面的教会。
So in the Old Testament, in the book of Hebrews, it talk about the tabernacle in the wilderness. Actually, that tabernacle is the church.
所以旧约的 tabernacle 那个 gathering 哪一个联合，基本上就是新约里面的教会。
So the tabernacle in the Old Testament is the shadow of the church in the New Testament.
然后到新约的时候是 apostolic church， 就是 New Testament apostolic church， 是新约时代里面的教会。
So and then when it comes to New Testament, it is the apostolic church.
这其实这个教会就是一个祭司。
And that church is the priesthood.
The priesthood. 然后呢，到了先几年呢，这一个祭司会带到更高境界。
And then when we get to the millennium, this priesthood reach even greater heights.
为什么？
Why?
因为在先几年里面，这个祭司呢是与君王一同的工作的。
Because in the millennium, this priesthood works side by side with the kingship.
按照以斯帖四十八章里面所谈到的圣殿，其实这个灵里面所谈到的圣殿。
According to the temple that is mentioned in Ezekiel 48 in spiritual realm,、
就是祭司们的旧约里面呢，就献祭，祭司就是预备祭物，然后献祭的。
That in the Old Testament, the priests they prepare the offering and then they make this offer sacrifice.
但在先几年里面呢，写明是什么？那个祭司的预备好东西，预备好祭物，是王子来献祭的。
But in the millennium, the Bible says that it is the priest who prepare the sacrifice, but then it is the prince who makes the offering.
所以本来这个王君王与祭司是河水不犯井水的。
So originally, this priesthood and the kingship they are divided, as in they don't, they do their own job, they don't.
但是神在以赛亚书里面写到，在先几年里面，他要把祭司与君王两者融合。
But God has written in the book of Isaiah that in the millennium, the priesthood and kingship are going to come together.
所以这个祭司带到一个更高的境界。
So this priesthood is brought to even greater heights.
还带着君王的灵。
It brings forth, it carries the spirit of kingship.
从旧约里面的先知，什么是先知？
From the prophets in the Old Testament, what is the prophet?
神说，我在旧约里面说，我做事情不会做事情，除非我先告诉先知。
So God says that in the Old Testament that he will not do anything without first telling his prophet.
神在旧约里面说什么？
And what did he say in the Old Testament?
在以色列民中，我再不会兴起先知，好像摩西。
That amongst the Israelites, I'm not going to raise another prophet as like Moses.
因为摩西是什么？是耶和华面对面所认识的。
Because Moses knew the Lord face by face to face.
所以你看见先知的境界就是与神亲密到不得了的地步。
So you can see that the prophetic realm, the prophet is very close to the Lord face to face.
Yeah. 这个是先知。
That is prophet.
所以他可以把神的心告诉其他的人。
So he's able to tell other people of the heart of God.
在新约的时候，圣灵在我们里面，每一个人都有先知性的灵。
And in the New Testament, the Holy Spirit is inside us, and every person has a spirit, a prophetic
spirit. 每一个人都能够在 prophecy, 在神的灵的感动里面，把神的心分享给人。
Everyone in the moving of the Holy Spirit can share the heart of God to other people.
先知的原则也没有变。
And this principle for prophet has not changed.
先知不是来预言的。
Prophet is not to prophesy about future.
先知乃是在这个时代里面最了解神心里面的人。
Prophet are people in that era that are most understanding of the heart of God.
这个其实是我谈的密契神学，密契派。
And that is what I want to talk about in mystical theology.
先知境界就是密契派。
And the prophetic realm is the mystical realm.
密契派，密契境界就是先知境界。
And mystical realm is the prophetic realm.
为什么
？Why？
因为他们明白神的心。
Because they understand the heart of God.
所以这个礼拜天我会告诉你们一篇信息，非常好的。
So this Sunday I'm going to share with you a very good message.
是讲到心心相印。
It talks about heart to heart, keeping close to the Lord's heart.
就是讲到密契派里面的追求。与神之间这个亲密情度是何等的宝贵。
It talks about this mystical pursuit and this intimacy with the Lord.
你知道你知道你做基督徒了，你最重要的是什么
？You know, as a Christian, what is most important for you?
就知道神很爱你。
To know that the Lord loves you very much.
是不是最重要
？Isn't that the most important?
是不是对你来说，如果你知道神很爱你，如果天打开，这是我的爱子，我所喜悦。如果这样子呢，你就会。特别快乐的。
Isn't that the most important to you that if the sky, heavens open and God says to you, this is my, you are my beloved son and I'm, son, I'm pleased with you, that that will be happiest for you. Yeah,
在人世间呢，最亲密的就是一个夫妻的相爱，爱情的相爱。
And in this world, the closest relationship or intimacy is husband and wife.
所以一个密契的高手就是在灵里面与主成为一灵的。
So a mystical master is able to, in the spirit, to become in one spirit with the Lord.
他是真的明白神的心。
And that person would truly understand the heart of God.
为什么他知道神爱他
？So why is it that he knows that God loves him?
因为神在幔内里面用口与他亲嘴，他的爱情比酒更美。
Because God kisses him with his lips, and his the love is sweeter than wine beyond the veil.
Yeah. 所以呢，我们这个礼拜天呢会谈到如何进入这一个与主心心相印的境界。
So this Sunday we're going to talk about how do we enter into this intimacy of heart to heart with the Lord.
因为神要在先禧年里面把他的渔民，把他的拿太教会带进一个更高层次的先知境界。
Because God wants to bring His remnants to even higher prophetic realm.
不是为了发预言，不是为了发预言。
Not for the purpose of prophesying.
乃是带出神的道。
But to bring forth the word of God.
带出神的心。
To bring forth the heart of God.
并且在这个时代里面，我们的灵是与他心心相印。
And that in this era, that our heart is so close and intimate with the Lord's heart. We are heart to heart.
旧约里面有君王体系。
In the Old Testament, there is a kingship system.
君王体系呢是很严厉的，它基本上是带出一个审判。
Kingship system is very serious and stern. It brings forth judgment.
Yeah, 因为你犯罪，他就把你处死。
Because if you sin, then you will be beheaded.
Yeah, 这个不是这个祭司做的工作。
This is not the work of a priest.
也不是先知做的工作。
And it is not the work of prophet.
是君王做的工作。
It is the work of king.
是吗？所以呢，大卫呢？曾经呢，在这个山洞里面呢，给这个扫罗追杀。
So, David was being persecuted or chased down by the Saul in the cave.
然后呢，到有一个机会呢，大卫有机会可以杀吧扫罗，但是他没有杀他。
And then there was an opportunity where David could have killed Saul, but he didn't.
他只是把他的衣襟割了一下来。
He just sliced off a hem of
his sleeve, right? His sleeve. 然后呢，就让扫罗知道，哎 ，I could kill you then, but I did not kill you.
And that was a message to let Saul know that David was capable of killing him, but he did not.
你们记得这个故事吗
？You know that story, right?
Right. It's simple, right? 是不是大卫很有？他说，哎，神的受膏者啊，我不可以碰。
Is it because David feels like, oh, Saul is the anointed person of God, so I cannot touch him?
Yeah. 然后呢，扫罗最后跟大卫打仗的里面呢。有一次呢， 就受伤了。
So there was one time in battle that Saul got hurt in the
然后扫罗呢就告诉一个少年人呢去把他杀死。
And Saul asked a young person to kill him.
Yeah, 然后这个小人人呢以为哎我杀了大卫的敌人，就告诉大卫说哎我杀了扫罗。
And then this young man was happy that he thinking that he has killed the enemy of David, so he ran to David rejoicing that hey I've killed Saul. The enemy.
以为可以领功啊。
Thinking that he will get rewarded.
大卫怎么说？
What did David say?
你杀了神的受膏者，你都要死。
You killed God's anointed one. You have to die too.
你看见这个君王体系是不是？好像是很受尊重。
So you can see that this kingship system is very feared and respected.
大卫还为扫罗死，扫罗死了做了他的哀歌，英雄怎么何等何其要灭亡。
So in Saul's death, David composed a very sad tune to praise his heroic deeds. It's a song.
是不是君王是很受大卫尊重，因为扫罗虽然不好，但是他是神受膏的君王。
So even Saul was not good, but he was anointed by God to be king, and so David respected Saul.
什么？可以杀你都不杀你。
Even David was able to kill Saul, he did not.
就算我与你打仗，有人把你杀你。杀死你，我也要杀这个人。
Even though I had a war with you and someone killed you, then I killed the person who killed you.
Yeah.就算你死了，我也写哀歌。
Even though Saul you died, I still wrote you a song.
但是
，But
扫罗死了之后
，After Saul was dead,
大卫就去扫罗里面找他所有的全家。
David searched out every single member of Saul's family.
是吗？把他的全家吊在树上死
，And hung every one of them on a tree.
就是猪狗族这样子 like Chinese.
That is the way of how Chinese kill your whole family or your relatives.
只剩下约拿丹，因为他大卫爱约拿丹，所以约拿丹的儿子都不需要死。
Except Jonathan's son, because David was in love with Jonathan, and that the son did not have to die.
你看，当大卫没有做王之前呢，他非常尊重扫罗。
So you can see that before David ascended to the throne, he incredibly respected Saul.
无论扫罗多不好，他都很尊重他。
No matter how bad Saul was, David respected Saul.
但是大卫做了王
，But after David ascended to the throne,
所有以前所讲的什么 honor 都没有。
All the honor that was talked about before is gone.
他要去把所有扫罗所有的家人所有的朋友通通杀死。
David killed every single family member in Saul's family.
并且是死得很惨。
And they died a terrible death.
吊在树上。
Hang on a tree.
是啊，这个叫做什么？
So what is this called?
君王的灵。
That is the spirit of kingship.
所以你看见在新约里面。
So you can see in the New Testament.
阿拿尼亚。撒菲拉
Ananias and Sapphira,
欺控圣灵
they were cheating and
其实他们讲的大话是很他们都奉献只是没有奉献那么完全
well they lied they did offer but they just did not offer as much as they claimed they
因为那个时候要所有都拿出来但是他们怕所有拿出来不好所以我们留下一点给自己
because everyone at that time offered everything that they have but they just kept a little bit for themselves
彼得立刻用君王的灵把他们两个人杀死。
So Peter immediately with the spirit of kingship caused them to die.
Kingship is very it's the judgment spirit. Judgment spirit is the kingship spirit. It's pretty scary. 你可不可以想象，如果你去教会，如果你翻车，有人会杀你的
？Can you imagine if you go to church and you made a mistake and someone can kill you？
因为你本来要奉献所有，但是你奉献一半。然后你老公老婆都被圣灵所击杀。
Because originally you were to offer up everything you have, but you just offered half, so the husband and wife got killed.
你不是说，教会不是讲爱的吗？
Would you be saying, oh, maybe the church?
教会不是讲怜悯的吗？
Oh, doesn't the church talk about mercy?
And there's no warning. 彼得没有说，你们两个不要讲大话。如果你讲大话，我们要杀你。没有 warning， 就是立刻把他杀。
Peter did not give any warning to them, saying that, "Oh, do not lie. If you lie, this will happen." But they just got killed.
所以保罗说到，你们在教会里面博饼的时候
So Paul was saying when you are having communion in the church,
有些人不懂得薄饼干翻主的身体，所以他们病的很多，死的也不小。
That there are people who do not know how to break the bread and they offended the Lord, and there are many who got sick and even those who died.
谁杀他们？
So who killed these people?
圣灵。
The Holy Spirit.
教会不是讲爱的吗？
Oh, doesn't the church talk about love?
难得一家人能够在基督里面合一合一，然后我们这个薄饼不是很漂亮、很快乐的事情吗？
Isn't it a happy thing to have the family of church gather together and break the bread and share time of communion together?
但是初期教会里面呢，很多人死，很多人病。
But in the New Testament church, a lot of people got sick and a lot of people died.
因为他们薄饼是干犯了主的身体。
Because when they break the bread, they offended the body of Christ.
啊，我可以讲更多的例子给你看。
I can give you even more examples.
这个不是旧约。
This is not Old Testament.
是初期教会新约。
This is the New Testament, the first century church.
但是你看见今天的教会没有这样子的。君王的灵的那么可怕的是吧
？But you can see that nowadays churches we see that they don't have the scary spirit of kingship.
如果这样子的教会没有人敢去了是吧
？If there is such church, nobody dares to go.
但是我告诉你
，But I'll tell you，
千禧年里面
，In the millennium，
这个君王的灵又再一次的回来
，Will come back.
旧约里面有
，There is such a kingship spirit in the Old Testament.
带出审判
，It brings forth judgment.
没有什么。什么怜悯呢？是非常严厉的审判。
And there is no mercy, but it is very stern judgment.
新约里面有。
And then also it exists in the New Testament.
保罗说：“这一个人那么坏，我把他交给撒旦。”
Paul said that, "Oh, this person is so evil. I'm going to hand him over to Satan."
让他败坏他，让撒旦来败坏你的肉体。
So that Satan may spoil his physical body.
这一个咒诅是不是很可怕
？Isn't that a horrible, horrible curse?
如果牧师说：“哎。”
If the pastor says.
这个人不听话，在教会里面不听话。
Oh, this person is church is behaving bad.
我现在要把这个人交给撒旦。
I'm going to hand this person over to Satan.
让撒旦去咬他、打他，甚至杀害他、败坏他的肉体。
Corrupt this person's physical body and kill him or destroy this person.
如果我这样子讲话，你是不是哇？这一个牧师是不是很可怕
？If I speak like that, wouldn't you say, "Wow, this is a horrible pastor"?
保罗做的就是这样子。
Well, that's what Paul did.
All the time, 在新约里面运行的君王的灵是很可怕的。
In the New Testament, the moving of the spirit of kingship is very scary.
所以旧约里面有君王、有祭司、有先知。
So in the Old Testament, there is kingship, priesthood, and there's prophet.
在新约里面都有君王，这个君王的灵是隐藏在教会里面。运行在教会里面，有君王，有祭司，有先知。
And in the New Testament, there is kingship and priesthood and prophet. This kingship is hidden in the church.
现在我们来到千禧年。
And then now we come to millennium.
我们有君王。
We have kingship.
我们有先知。
We have our prophets.
我们也有祭司。
And we have priesthood.
I'm so ready to take it into a different level. 我知道神要在千禧年里面。带出最完全的教会。
I know that God is bringing forth the most complete and perfect church in the millennium.
有君王的灵。
It has the spirit of.
有耶和华审判的灵。
It has the spirit of judgment of Jehovah.
不是单单讲爱的。
And not just only talking about love.
也不是单单谈怜悯的。
And not just only talking about mercy.
他是谈审判的。
But he's talking about judgment.
因为神的圣洁、神的荣光降临在他的殿中。
Because God's holiness and His glory descends to His temple.
这一个男的教会会兴起先知。
And this man-child church will rise a prophet.
他们是与主心心相印的。
They are heart to heart to the Lord.
他们是与主成为一灵的。
They're in one spirit with the Lord.
他们是被神的话、神的道充满的。
They're filled with the word of God.
他们是学道。
They learn the word,
活道,
and they live out the word,
然后成道,
and they become the word.
这个先知境界会达到更高,
and we will reach a high level of this prophetic realm.
然后旧约里面的祭司,
and then the priesthood in the Old Testament,
新约里面的教会, 新约教会祭司,
and then in the New Testament, it is the priesthood church.
然后 现行的里面是以斯帖四十八章里面那个圣殿里面的祭司。
And in the millennium, it is the Ezekiel 48, the temple, the priesthood inside the temple.
里面是与君王的灵融合在一起。
And it is united with the spirit of kingship in there together.
所以基督教里面的三大系统，君王、祭司与先知。
So the three great systems of kingship, priesthood, and prophet in Christianity
都要在先禧年这个荣耀的时代里面完全的合而为一。
And they will all come together in one in this glorious millennium.
并且带到完全的地步。
And to enter into its perfection.
Okay? 所以现在这个火凤凰来一个 COVID 的洗礼是 OK 的。
So it is okay now that there is this baptism of COVID for this phoenix to rise again.
Yeah, everybody just brace yourself, right? 每一个人带上你的安全带 yeah. Try to be safe, right? 但是也不需要害怕
So try to be safe, you don't need to be afraid.
如果你没有染上的感谢神
If you did not catch COVID, then praise the Lord.
如果你染上的感谢神
If you got COVID positive, praise the Lord.
因为你染上以后也会好的，你不会死的，所以是 OK, OK.
Because after, even if you got positive, you will recover, you will not die, you will be OK.
不是好像以前开始的那个 COVID 呢那个 Boris Johnson 呢都带着气管啊，快要死了，很可怕。
So not like at the beginning of COVID where you saw the UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson, he was having difficulty breathing.
然后以开始的 COVID 呢，好像千斤针刺在心。
And at that time, COVID is like you have thousands of needles poking your
lungs. That's what they said. Your lungs will turn into glass. You know, it's like very scary. Oh my God! You know, 就是千斤针刺在心，就是这样。
That was the beginning of COVID. It was very bad to the
world. 现在是现行年了。
Right now, we're in the millennium.
Trump 总统呢，他染了 COVID.
Trump did contract COVID.
在他80岁的高龄里面染了严重的 COVID.
In his old age of 80s, he caught a very intense
Not the light COVID, it's a real COVID. 并且在 COVID 的很厉害的时候染的。
And he got it in when COVID was very, very strong.
所有恨他的，哎，好啦，那 COVID 他没有命了。
All those people who hated Trump was rejoicing, thinking that he would die.
所以三天之后
，But 3 days later,
他又好了。
He got up and he recovered.
三天之后，从死里面复活了。
He arose from the dead.
因为他是古列王。
Because he's King Cyrus.
Okay. 并且他很快回来。
And he's coming back soon.
我不是讲到2024。
I'm not talking about 2024.
我讲的是很快。
I'm saying very soon.
其实他一直都在掌权。
Actually, all this time he has been in power.
我们有足够的证据，他是一直在掌权。
We know from all evidences, solid evidences that he has been in power.
但当然，我们现在不在乎这个东西。
But right now we are not going to debate about this thing.
因为现在有一件事情是确实。
Because right now, there's one thing we know.
神掌权。
That God reigns.
我们是他眼中的瞳仁。
We are the apple of his eyes.
我们是在所有时代的风云翻转里面。
We are in all the, amongst all the storms in all the eras.
神的一切都是为着保全着这个渔民。
And God does all things in order to protect his remnant.
世界如果很好是为了保存这个渔民。
If the world is in a good shape, it is to protect the remnant.
世界如果很糟糕是为了保全这个渔民。
If the world turns into a horrible state, it is to protect the
remnant. 如果美国很堕落是为了保全这个渔民。
If USA becomes very corrupted, then it is for protecting the remnant.
如果 COVID 很厉害一个洗礼也是为了造就这个渔民。
If COVID becomes a very horrible baptism of death, it is for
edifying the remnant. Everything that God does is for the remnant. The remnant is all that matters. This is a theological statement that is right aboard, always right. Okay, 这个很重要的。神做的一切事情都是为了他的渔民。所以我讲的不是讲到，哦，我要在基督教里面是，我是基督徒。
So what I'm talking about is not that, oh, in Christianity realm, I'm a Christian.
我们要谈的拿特里教会是什么？我们是要做这个渔民。
When we're talking about being the man-child church, we're saying we want to be the remnant.
是神所保守在以利亚的日子里面这7000个不相巴力去世的人。
It is the 7,000 remnant whom God has protected in the times of Elijah that has not nailed to Baal.
是神要兴起 这个君士坦丁去改变整个罗马的，为了保全这一群的渔民。
It is a group of remnant that God has moved Emperor Constantine to make Christianity the religion of the state to protect the remnant.
德国残害这个以色列犹太人的时候呢，有一群的渔民来到了。逃离开 miraculously.
It is the remnant who had miraculously escaped from the Holocaust.
在美国这个很丰富的很多人都堕落的地方。
And in USA, in this materially abundant place where a lot of people get spoiled and corrupted,
神兴起了他的男孩子教会。
God has raised up His man-child church.
I'm so honored to be working for you all because you guys.Are not just Christians. I want to work with the remnant of the kingdom of the Most High. And you guys are the remnant. 我希望我 I'm talking to the remnants. 所以我们在这一个境界里面呢，我们知道先几年里面神要如何把我们成就。
So I know how God in this millennium will fulfill us.
So you guys ready to...Go through this baptism. 有些人呢 go through the baptism 呢是全身好像落汤鸡一样的出来。
There are some people who go through this baptism like a chicken putting in the boiling broth.
也有人好像是 crystal, 好像天使一样的到水里面去，水里面上来，全身都没有一滴水。
There are some people who are like a crystal who gets into this boiling broth and then come out and she doesn't get it wet.
但是我们每一个人经过这个洗礼
，But every one of us we go through this baptism，
好像火凤凰
，Just like the fire phoenix，
在世界所有的巨变里面
，So even amongst all the great changes and things happening in the world，
rebirth， 浴火重生
，The phoenix is reborn from the fire。
这一个我刚才讲的话，这个灵呢，特别在我们的 Wing 姊妹身上。是最最完全。
And the spirit that I'm just talking about is most perfect in Wing, Sister Wing.
Yeah, 因为她的 spirit 其实就是这个火凤凰。
Because her spirit is this fire phoenix.
所以她会，她经过很多苦难。
She had gone through a lot of tribulations and sufferings.
并且在所有人都要经过苦难之前呢，她是第一个前锋。
And she's like the spearhead, often experiencing the sufferings before everyone else goes through it.
真正神的教会就是这样子。
And that is the true church of God.
They are the spearhead of the will of God. 所有神的旨意，他们是前锋。所以这个千禧年是什么时代？
So what is this era of the millennium?
是一个荣耀的时代。
It is a glorious era.
所以谁会最开启荣耀？
So who will first enter into this glory?
男孩子教会。
The man-child church.
先几年是一个审判的时代。
And the millennium era is an era of judgment.
全世界都要受审判。
The whole world is getting judged.
但是圣经说，
But the Bible tells us,
审判是从神的家开始。
The judgment begins from the house of God.
We're the spirit, we're the remnant. 我把时间交给 Mindy.